You're still angry?
Yes. Yes, I am.
I understand it was bad timing for Jill to spring all that on you, having just come from the funeral.
Exactly. We have buried the secret of the location of the mortuary shrine of Marit Karar, thanks to Jillian's negligence. I asked her, I do not know how many times, to make sure that someone other than Spencer knew where the shrine was located, but now he's dead, and we have no way of finding Marit Karar. And Jillian is jeopardizing this entire situation by involving a journalist in all this.
I understand how furious you are with Jill for telling an outsider without consulting you. But I wish I could reassure you about Jack Finelli. If he says he will keep it quiet, he will. There is no other man who respects a professional ethic as much as Jack. You still don't trust him?
I have no reason to. He has yet to prove himself to me. And as you know, where Marit Karar's shrine is concerned, I trust no one. Faith, you don't seem to understand yet how valuable it is. Marit Karar is the last Egyptian ruler whose tomb or mummy has yet to be found. Her discovery is very important. There are too many people in too many countries who are too interested. If any one of them should find out that she's here before I found the shrine and assured it...
I understand your concern. And I think you're overreacting. First of all, if only the three of us and Jack Finelli know about it, it is not worldwide news. I think what you should do is go and talk to Jack and tell him exactly what is at stake. He has guaranteed his silence. Maybe by talking to him, it will reassure you. Plus, I think it will make him sympathetic towards you, which will be invaluable to you when you do need publicity.
You're right, of course. One of the worst mistakes Howard Carter made in the Tutankhamun affair was alienating the press. I'll do as you say.
Good.
Why is it so much easier to listen to you than to Jillian? Perhaps I should apologize to Jillian. Maybe I did overreact.
Excuse me, Mr. Benedict White. There's a gentleman here to see you.
Oh, show him in, please, Mendenhall. Faith, I have a brief business appointment. Would you mind waiting in the foyer?
No, of course not. Joe.
Hello, Faith.
Excuse me.
To the glamour.
What are you doing here?
I had an appointment with my personal shopper.
Get in to the parties.
That is so intimate.
You're Nathan, me and Lucas.
Get in over your head.
I think I can get in less trouble where I'm from.
You have no idea.
Welcome to the OC, bitch.
Get into One Tree Hill in the OC. Weekdays at 5 and 6. Get in with SoapNet.
This July, SoapNet is fired up.
You watch your tongue.
The dispute around Sammy's pregnancy heats up.
Those whack job Demir is trying to kill you.
How will she make peace?
She's turning you into a lovesick puppy.
The heat is on.
Let me just cut to the chase.
Watch Days of Our Lives all July long on SoapNet.
How long can your sleek hair weather the weather? Garnier Fructis Sleek and Shine, the only smoothing system fortified with nourishing fruit micro oils from Garnier. The Fructis Sleek and Shine system makes hair 5 times stronger and 5 times smoother, even with moisture in the air. Sleeker, shinier hair? Goodbye frizz. For hair that shines with all its strength, Garnier Fructis Sleek and Shine. Garnier. Love your sleek look? Now you can lock it in. Introducing Garnier Fructis Style Sleek and Shine.
University understands how you live today and where you want to go tomorrow. University of Phoenix, thinking ahead.
When I signed up for Vonage, I was able to keep my phone number. And then when I moved, I was able to take it with me.
Vonage was so, so simple to set up. I did it on my own, and I was very proud of that.
Call quality is the utmost. It projects my business. And with Vonage, it's perfect.
Vonage and reliability, that just kind of goes hand in hand.
The features save you time. And that's really where I'm focused as far as cost goes.
It's made our connection that much closer. I love Vonage. There's no one else out there that fills the need that Vonage does. And I'm a lifer. I love it.
So sign up, set up, and start saving up to $300 a year on your phone bill.
It's just $24.99 a month for unlimited local and long distance. Call now and get 1 month free, including free calls to the U.S., Canada, Puerto Rico, and Europe.
Vonage, a better way to phone for less.
Well, it's not the sort of place I'm accustomed to.
But I can see that you appreciate beauty.
This collection must be worth a great deal.
You described an artifact to me when we spoke on the phone.
That's right. I have it with me.
May I? If this is genuine, it's irreplaceable.
It's genuine.
Where did you find this?
A friend of mine bought it from a dealer. The friend owed me some money and he couldn't repay it. So I agreed to accept this as a settlement of the debt.
I suspect you've made yourself a handsome profit.
So you're satisfied that it's legitimate?
Oh, yes. Why did you bring it to me?
Well, I heard your name mentioned several times at the Egyptian ball at the Crystal Palace. I thought you might be interested.
Does that mean that you have an association with the museum since you were at the ball?
No, I own the Crystal Palace.
I see. How much?
You don't waste time. I'm interested in hearing an offer.
It may disappoint you. This is a private museum. The acquisition fund is small. The most I can offer you is $7,500, and even that will be a strain. What you have here is a likeness of Merimtah, a ruler of the 19th dynasty. It's quite rare and worth many times more than $7,500 on the open market.
I'm aware of that. I came to you because I prefer to avoid the open market.
Could you tell me again where your friend acquired this item?
Well, I don't believe I told you a first time.
As you wish. It's just that items of this quality for sale, very unusual to find that in the United States.
Well, my business often involves unusual circumstances. I accept your offer. I'll be back when you have money at hand. Cash, please. Nothing larger than 20.
I understand. Would you like to leave the statue here for safekeeping?
No, thank you. I'll handle that. Don't worry. I'll take good care of it.
I'll get in touch with you as soon as possible. Shall I call you?
Yes, at the Crystal Palace.
I'll have the money for you early next week.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Pleasure is mine.
Bye, Faith.
Goodbye, Joe. Ari, do you know who that man is?
Hi, Meg.
Oh, hello, love. How was your day?
Exhausting, but good.
Well, help yourself to some tea. That's always good for exhaustion. What has Ray got you doing that you're so tired?
Oh, the same old stuff.
Are you... you're writing another story for the paper?
Yes, I am.
Well, you're being mighty mysterious.
It's that kind of story. I'm going to tell you about it as soon as I can.
Oh.
Ray Woodard is being so fantastic to me, Maeve. I just can't believe it. And when she hired me as Schultz's assistant, I thought I was going to have to work so hard to impress her. And I am, for sure. But I expected her to lean back and say, all right, impress me. And she's gone out of her way to make opportunities for me. I think she likes me. She even invited me to Thanksgiving dinner. But she seems so lonely sometimes.
I suppose she is. Her daughter and granddaughter are out of New York. They were very important to her.
Oh, that's a shame. She deserves to have the people she loves around her. Uh-oh, bad news.
Why do you say that?
Well, because you're the one person who always says something good about somebody if there's anything good to say. I bet you're the only person I've ever met who lives by that old saying, if you can't say something good, don't say anything at all. Seems to me you're not saying an awful lot.
Well, that's about it. Would you hand me that big knife over there? This one is no good for cutting carrots.
I guess Dee was right when she said,
Thank you, dear.
Ray had done lousy things to the Ryans. Well, I just have to go by how she's treated me, and so far she's been nothing but fantastic. Everybody has, you especially.
Oh.
And Johnny and Siobhan and Jack and Roger, even weird Wes Leonard. I love them all.
Well, of course, any friend of the Ryans, Maeve. Jane, how's work going? Any better for you? You still stuck sorting out Ray's paper clips?
Oh, dearie, please. Oh, Jane, dear, would you get that? I have a handful here.
I'll say she's a handful.
Ryan's.
Well, if it isn't my favorite Ryan, I'm so glad you answered.
So am I.
You remember the rain check you gave me on dinner when we were so abruptly interrupted by Delia and her shoulder?
Sure do. I have a reminder right here, large as life.
Delia?
Yep. How is the injured party?
Well, I think she's fine. I sent her to get some x-rays, and I can't see anything wrong.
Oh, like with some other folks we know.
As if I needed reminding. Anyway, I called you to see if you'd like to cash in on that rain check tonight.
I'd love to. Actually, it's a rain check for a rain check. We were going to have something to eat after drinks the other night.
All right. I had forgotten. How much rain could a rain check check if a
rain... It's not fair to quote me on anything I say when I've had too much to drink. Hold on. Would you mind if I ate out tonight?
Not at all, dear. Have a good time.
Okay, it's fine. What time shall I be there?
As soon as he can.
All right, good enough. I'll be right over. Well, so much for a quiet evening at home. But what's the point of moving to New York if you want to spend quiet evenings at home? Bye, see you later.
Bye-bye. I don't believe the nerve of her. Breezing into town and she never offers any help around here. Just because she's the new girl in town, she... and everybody's making a fuss over her, she expects she doesn't have to do her share of the work around here.
Well, perhaps you could set her an example, dear.
What?
Well, I could use a little help right this minute.
Well, what is it? Because I'm dressed to go to the Crystal Palace.
I just want you to watch that pot so it doesn't burn, and I'm going across the street to Chang's. I need some onions. I'll only be gone a minute.
Well, I guess I can do that. But you watch. You won't see Jane doing anything like this. She's too busy trying to get in good with Ray Woodard. She acts like this is some kind of hotel or something. Except it's free.
Dear, you really don't like her, do you?
Who said that? I just think that she's taking advantage of us a little, that's all. But why shouldn't I like her?
Patient.
How's she doing?
She's barely breathing.
We're gonna get you help, okay?
I've considered how my HIV would affect the life of a child, and then right about then, my brain just freezes up, and I tell myself to forget about the whole thing.
No!
One, two, three, up.
The SoapNet original series, General Hospital Night Shift, Thursdays at 11 p.m., only on SoapNet.
Starbucks iced coffee, a premium Italian roast coffee drink with a hint of non-fat milk and sugar.
Cut, please.
Wow, that's great coffee. Can I get another take?
Can a sanitary pad really keep you dry? Stay Free Dry Max Ultra Thin stays dry. It's 10 times drier than the leading Ultra Thin with its new Dry Lock Core.
Wow, still feels dry.
Dry Max Ultra Thin from Stay Free. Stay dry, stay free.
No castle in the south of France, but what we had were underpants. Our fruit was of the loom, not of the tree. Yet daddy was the apple of my eye. Like underwear, he's with me till I die.
I'll put it on vibrate.
Do you love spending hours working out at the gym? If you do, the Total Gym is not for you.
But if you want one of the fastest, most effective workouts ever, then the Total Gym is for you.
For our 10th anniversary, we have an incredible deal.
You can try the Total Gym in your home for an entire month, risk-free.
We'll ship you a Total Gym at our expense. If you don't see a remarkable change, just send it back, and we'll return every penny you were charged. But if you're like most of us, once you try it, you'll never want to be without it again.
Just 1 year on the Total Gym, and I've lost 45 pounds.
So take our risk-free challenge and get the body you've always wanted. Why go to the gym when you can own one?
Call the number on your screen for our anniversary special. Try the Total Gym in your home risk-free for 60 days. We'll pay shipping and handling. Call now.
Hey, Daddy, want to bring up?
Now, is that all I'm good for?
His girls meant the world to him.
Think it's time for y'all to go to bed.
No! 5 more minutes.
But when he lost them...
Full custody with the mother. Father will have visitation 1 day a week.
He lost all hope.
I gotta talk to you about my kids.
I think we have a really solid case.
Daddy, we just want to be with you.
Tyler Perry's Daddy's Little Girls.
What's at the end of a rainbow?
I would have been here on 30 seconds flat, but up in the corner I passed a woman having car trouble, so I stopped to see what was wrong. It was no fun sitting in a non-familiar street with a non-functioning car, especially when it's getting dark so early outside. So I stopped to help her.
That's one of your more appealing traits. What happened?
And transmission fluid had run dry, so I found a garage and bought a couple quarts and filled up the reservoir. It's no big deal.
You never cease to amaze me.
Oh, good. I always wanted to be a woman of mystery, an enigma, sphinx-like.
I always yearned for one, but I never expected that she'd be mechanically inclined. It just goes to show you what delightful surprises that fate has in store for you.
I was thinking that my mechanical aptitude is going to come in handy on this assignment for Miss Woodard.
Why is that?
Because I plan to fix Barbara Wilde's wagon. Bad, yeah. No, seriously, though, this talent means more to me than anything else other than writing. I can always get a job as a mechanic. They're in great demand. And it makes me feel special. My father said it made me a loser.
Why?
I don't know. I suppose because I could strip the engine of his car and put it back together again, and he couldn't even put air in the tires. You can't be interested in my career as a mechanic. Stop me.
I'm fascinated.
Oh.
Jane, nothing heavy this evening, just a simple dinner, relaxed atmosphere, mingled with my undivided attention, and no Wes Leonard.
Sounds nice.
Good.
If anyone had told me a year ago that I would be where I am now, and in a place like this, with someone like you, wine. I probably would have fallen down laughing.
I think you fit perfectly in a place like this with a person like me, with the wine.
Roger. You know, tomorrow would have been an anniversary for us. Anniversary of our official engagement. And you know who he's spending his time with.
Well, perhaps he'd be spending it with you if you hadn't lied to him and used him so badly.
Maeve, Roger deliberately made me lose all my money on that gold mine deal.
Well, if he's done all the terrible things that you say he has, you know what I would tell you. Don't you?
What? Be generous in spirit even though I'm angry with him?
Exactly.
Well... How am I supposed to do that? I know. I know what to do for Roger. Generous in spirit? Yes, hello. I'd like to send a telegram.
I know I've told you this before, but I'm so glad you came to New York.
Oh, you can tell me that a lot. Tell me why.
I like surprises. And I particularly like to be surprised by a woman. Especially since I'd begun to think that I'd seen them all.
I like that. I don't think I've ever felt so appreciated before.
Hold it. They don't live here.
Isn't this the corner of Claremont and Riverside?
Yes, but...
All right. I have to deliver the message.
Well, look, can't you just, you've got the wrong people.
Do you want me to get fired? I'll lose my job if I don't deliver this.
Can't you just hand me the thing?
No, I've got to sing it.
Oh, let the lady sing, boss.
It's Harry and Fa's anniversary. Happy 30th to Harry and Fa's. This telegram's from Sally and Percy. We hope you are happy because Harry, Fa's, we love you because you're our mom and dad. Harry, Fa's, you raised us and we're awful glad. Signed, Sally and Percy, your kids.
I knew it was a great idea to get rid of those kids years ago.
Yeah, here. Thank you.
What?
What were we saying?
I think it's going to be kind of hard to pick up where we left off. Maybe we should just have dinner.
But I was just enjoying the start.
I was, too. But I've come to my senses now, and I think it's best.
Why?
Trust me. I'll know when the time is right.
All right, Elizabeth Jane. The one thing we have is time.
Thank you.
Ryan's Hope is next. Then Dangerous Desires at night on Days. Later, Little Lies lead to Big Trouble on AMC. Only on SoapNet.
We lost a patient this morning.
Why did he have to die?
I am entitled to some answers.
Not after what you did.
Let's call a truce.
I can't do this anymore. It's finished.
Till death do us part.
You'll never know how much that means to me.
You've never taken my side. I hate you. You hate me.
This marriage isn't over.
I've made up my mind. I hate that I have to walk away from the father of my children. I just want to hold him.
Oh, L'Amour, Days of Our Lives, tonight at 7, only on SoapNet.
Tonight on SoapNet.
Lucky, I can't do this.
Do you love Jason?
Families shattered.
You had been sharing a secret with another woman.
We're over.
The truth is coming.
If Elizabeth is lying, what is she lying about?
Watch General Hospital tonight at 10 on SoapNet.
Hey, Ernie, word in the tree is there's another Sandy's Drops cookie.
Indeed, new butter pecan drops.
Wow, but how do you know it has just the right amount of sweetness?
The just right-o-meter.
Right.
Keebler's Sandy's Drops cookies.
Stu, how does Tidy Cat's litter work?
Well, each granule is formulated to absorb quickly and lock in odor better than ever.
So can I invite some friends?
Yes.
Tidy Cats. Multiple strengths for multiple cats.
They can be aviation electricians, healthcare technicians, computer technicians. But no matter which path they choose, they all start right here.
I did all my research, and I can get money for college.
If your son or daughter wants to talk about the Army, listen. You made them strong. We'll make them Army strong. To learn more about the Army's 150 different career opportunities, visit GoArmy.com.
I know that his name is Joe Novak and that he owns the Crystal Palace, nothing more.
Well, I'm not surprised he didn't tell you more about himself. There's very little he can tell and still sound respectable.
What do you know about him?
He is a criminal. He has lived his whole life among criminals. His uncle was a very important figure in the underworld. And Joe has spent his whole life training to take over the organization.
Has any of this been proven?
He's never been convicted on any charge. He was just recently arrested for running an illegal gambling operation, and I doubt that will stick. Joe has a high-priced lawyer that specializes in Joe's type.
I see.
Well, I have all the proof I need. He was married, well, no, he still is married, legally anyway, to a very close friend of mine. And he lied to her from the first day they met. He's acted bad faith professionally and personally. You can't trust a word that man says.
I'll admit I'm not surprised.
Oh?
Yes, he came to me with an item he wishes to sell. From his description, it's an artifact from the 19th dynasty, and rare and very valuable. It would be an interesting acquisition for the Marie Caron collection.
Well, if it's genuine, it's stolen.
Well, the answer to both those questions remains to be seen. Once I've examined the artifact, I'll know if it's genuine. And when I hear Mr. Novak's asking price, I'll know if it's stolen.
But you would reject an illegitimate deal.
Oh, Faith, I assure you, I would never do anything that was improper.
I'm relieved to hear that. But I'd be happier if you had nothing more to do with Joe. You'd be making a serious mistake if you got mixed up with that man.
Brenda, Kelly, and Donna hang with the gals of Beverly Hills and relive their rocky friendships, greatest heartaches, and ugliest fights. Don't miss Beverly.
Thank you.
Jonas.
Julianne.
I'm surprised to see you here so early. I'm glad to see that you're as anxious to begin as I am.
Well, Jonas was kind enough to agree to go through Spencer's papers with me first thing this morning. He was very helpful. We went through Spencer's desk and all the files, but we found no further instructions for you, Ari.
I see. Well, in that case, I'll simply have to rely on my own instincts and judgment.
And anyone who is aware of your work is aware of the soundness of them both.
Of course.
Thank you. Well, if you'll excuse me, I don't want to waste any more time. As Mendenhall has said, Spencer did like things done promptly and in order. I have a lot to do.
Ari, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid that's impossible.
I know you're concerned about Maggie's integrity, but it won't hurt to listen, will it? Harry and Hannah are new to the show. Give them a chance.
Oh, how much of a chance? Do you expect me to accept a destructive plot because the writers are new?
No. But our working relationship with them is going to be much more difficult if you start rejecting their ideas before they've had a chance to give you the whole pitch. Now, I know you are both open-minded and fair, Barbara.
Cut the flattery, Forrest. I have a reputation in this business, but open-minded is not the first thing that comes to people's mind when my name is mentioned. And I don't have to be fair because at this moment the ratings are highest they've been in 6 years.
Because you are in the news, but that won't last forever. And neither will the novelty of a wheelchair-bound actress playing a disabled woman. I mean, how long can that story play? Maybe another 6 or 8 weeks? We need something that will hold the viewers who have started tuning in. Now, if we're going to keep those ratings high...
You don't have to do a sleazy, cheap plot about a porn queen to show that. Yes.
Morning. Hi. Oh, I'm sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to see if there was anything I could do for you.
Yes, you can. Come in. Close the door. I want to try this out on Jane.
What? Now, Barbara, come on. Dan told me I shouldn't...
She will be discreet, won't you?
You can count on it. For what?
Else.
Who are you?
Whoever you want me to be.
Has everything they want.
Well, let's go.
Do you fit in?
Welcome to the dark side.
Or do you fight?
You know what I like about rich kids?
Nothing. Every weekday at 6.
Come on!
Soapnet brings you back to the OC.
Think I can get in less trouble where I'm from.
You have no idea.
Pretty people. Pretty messed up.
My mom ditched me. I burned your wife's house down. How is this going to be okay?
The OC. Weekdays at 6. Only on Soapnet.
If what Spinelli says doesn't compute, plug it into Soapnet Spinelliator.
The blonde one.
That's Lulu, the object of Spinelli's desires.
The unworthy one.
Is Logan, Spinelli's competition. Then there's...
Stone Cold.
Jason Morgan, he's all muscle. Crack Spinelli's codes by watching GH, tonight at 10 on Soapnet.
Degree Women. Secret's fragrance gradually fades over time. Degree Women responds with extra bursts of fragrance all day long. Protection that works in sync with your body. Degree Women.
There's a place called Hidden Valley where kids not only eat their vegetables, they can't get enough. Hidden Valley Ranch makes vegetables delectable.
Working late giving you dry eyes? Introducing Visine Tears Lasting Relief. Its advanced dry eye formula is made to stay on the eye longer for relief that lasts.
Finally!
New Visine Tears Lasting Relief.
Ask your prescriber about Ambien CR, then call or visit AmbienCR.com for a 7-day free trial offer. It's the only sleep aid with 2 layers of sleep relief. The first dissolves quickly to help you fall asleep fast. Plus, unlike other sleep aids, there's a second layer that dissolves slowly to help you stay asleep. Ambien CR is a treatment option you and your prescriber can consider along with lifestyle changes and can be taken for as long as your prescriber recommends. Until you know how Ambien CR will affect you, you shouldn't drive or operate machinery. Be sure you're able to devote 7 to 8 hours to sleep before being active again. Somnambulism with amnesia for the event and rare cases of severe allergic reactions have been reported. If you experience these events, contact your prescriber immediately. Side effects may include next-day drowsiness, dizziness, and headache. It's non-narcotic. However, like most sleep aids, it has some risk of dependency. Don't take it with alcohol. Ambien CR, for a good night's sleep from start to finish.
Barbara, please, you know as well as I do, it's very poor policy to share the long story with the cast. It hasn't even been approved by the network. It could change.
I hope it will change. I'm willing to admit that I'm wrong. I want an unbiased opinion. And Jane is one person in the cast I can trust. She's not involved in the long story. She's very discreet, and she's very candid, which you have been before, dear.
Much to the director's dismay, I must add.
That's all right. We care about the integrity of the program.
I shared the story with Barbara because it is a radical departure from the story and for the character of Maggie. But I felt she should be prepared. Now she wants your reaction. I hate having to play the bad guy, but Barbara has put me in a very embarrassing position.
Well, look, I understand. I'm sorry for barging in.
Jane. Maybe I can break the rule this once. But I want your pledge that you will not breathe a word of this to anyone on pain of death.
You got it.
We're introducing a new character, Shay Michaels. She's a waif-like little woman who comes to work on the newspaper with Anne. Anne introduces her to Maggie. Now, there is a mystery in Shay's past, something of which she is ashamed and which frightens her. Maggie takes her in and eventually discovers that Shay is a former porno film star. Now, Shay's boyfriend and ex-co-star, Mick, follows her to town. Now, Maggie becomes entangled with their lives. All right, now we are gonna play the contrast between Maggie's values and the life that Shay is trying to leave behind.
Between bad taste and our former high standards.
I thought you wanted an unbiased opinion.
I'm sorry.
Well, so Shay is the hooker, or the porn star in this case, with a heart of gold, and the boyfriend is the villain?
If you have to phrase it in terms of stereotypes, yes.
Well, what do you think?
Well, one more question now. It seems the porn star angle is the major issue. How do you establish this with an audience? Do we watch porn films?
Well, I mean, obviously, standards and procedures won't allow us to show pornographic film on national television. But I don't see why we can't use fragments. I mean, maybe show the performer's legs, perhaps some subliminal flashes of scenes that are not inherently obscene, but which suggest, you know, what comes next. It would have to be ironed out with the network.
Yes, I can see the censor's face now. What do you think?
Well, I know you must be appalled, and I can understand how you feel. But the viewers are with you. You can do anything you choose. So why resort to sleaze?
Exactly. Sleaze. That's exactly the word that was in my head.
But now, on the other hand, Maggie is the center of the show. She's very strong. She's so well-defined. Well, she's the role model for all the other characters, not to mention millions of American women. So this story wouldn't change that. And I think what's interesting here is not the two porn stars as such, even though I'm sure your synopsis didn't really do them justice. Obviously, the Harcourts are going to write them as well-developed, realistic characters, right? I think this is about Maggie's encounter with an alien world and how she discovers positive values in these two people who are representatives of that world. And what's really interesting is how she changes their lives and how they change hers. And if it's written to focus on Maggie and played with taste and honesty, well, oh, I know you can make it work.
Let me think about this, Forrest. Hannah and Harry wait a few days?
Oh, sure. And if you have any questions, get in touch with them. Listen, they want you to like this story, and they want you to work on it
with
them.
If I can catch them.
Oh, well, listen, I have a meeting with the network, and you have to camera block in a few minutes. Thanks so much for your help.
Oh, certainly.
Oh, don't mind him. You really have a gift of seeing both sides, and you made me see their side. Yes, I thought I was heading toward total disaster, and I really am not giving those new writers a chance.
Good. And look, if after a while the ratings are still up and you decide you don't like the idea, well, tell them you're not going to do it. I mean, the ratings are up because of you. You have a right to some input on the subject.
Yeah, if I can manage that tactfully without total rejection.
You can manage anything. You are the proud and the passionate.
Are you ready to cue me on Act Three? We have 5 minutes. You can be Hank.
Sure, sure.
Hank, what are you doing back from the plant?
I got off work early.
That's not like you. Yes?
Excuse me, Barbara.
Oh, hi, Jane. How's the new kid?
Oh, fine, thanks.
That's good. Listen, Barbara, Dr. Bolak's down in the studios. They'd like to see her.
You tell Dr. Bolak I'll be down in 5 minutes.
Sure thing.
Thank you.
Impossible.
I'm afraid so.
Why?
Because Jonas being executor of Spencer's will means that he has to seal off the house to take an inventory.
Well, surely there must be a list of the contents of the house already, if only for insurance purposes and nothing
else. Of course there is. Of course there is. And it has been double-checked. But as you well know, Spencer's collection is staggering. If even one object were missing, it might mean the loss of hundreds of thousands of dollars.
I understand, but why must your work interfere with mine? We needn't even be in the same sections of the house.
I'm afraid that won't do. At this point, no matter how careful we were, it would lead to too much confusion than I'm able to contemplate at this moment. I insist that the house be sealed. Oh, good grief. I've even had to put poor old Mendenhall out.
How long?
I don't know.
Give me a rough estimate, Jonas.
With luck, 2 or 3 days.
And without it?
2 or 3 weeks.
We both know that is a highly conservative estimate. A job like this could take a month or more. How many assistants would you hire?
This is the most important project I have ever undertaken in my life. And I will trust it to no one but myself.
I have a contract that guarantees me, as curator, immediate access to Spencer's entire collection upon his death. Will you honor that agreement or not?
Jonas's inventory does not change our deal or anything related to it.
It merely delays it.
All right. I realize that you have waited a long time for a project like this. A small, prestigious museum containing a collection of artifacts from the Middle Kingdom. But you have waited for years. Now, certainly you can be patient for another 3 weeks. Jonas's presence here is not going to interfere with your duties defined in the contract.
I can see this has all been carefully arranged so that I have absolutely no recourse.
Well, neither one of us can change anything. I am sorry.
Ari, I know you're impatient and I sympathize with you, believe me. But you have years ahead of you at the Smith Collection. Do try to bear with me for these few days.
Jonas, I'm sorry. Ari's dedication and his enthusiasm for his work, I think, are a lot stronger than his patience.
There is so much drama inside this hospital. It's hard to keep it covered up. Night Shift, the SoapNet original series, Thursdays at 11 p.m. on SoapNet.
Nathan Scott, MVP, a real team player.
Start taking notes.
Like steroids, reckless driving, and stealing school property.
Tell me we didn't just steal a school bus.
Dislikes his illegitimate brother.
Just quit the team, man.
Pretty hot, pretty messed up. One Tree Hill, today at 5 on SoapNet.
This July, SoapNet is fired up.
What is wrong with you people?
JR has brought on his father's ruin.
A pure, spineless, self-righteous jackass.
Can the Chandlers reunite and take back the family fortune?
No way in hell.
The heat is on.
Hit me.
Watch All My Children all July long on SoapNet.
Triple Blade Big Soleil. Now with replacement blades and an extra wide soothing moisture strip with aloe and shea butter. For smooth, beautiful skin, Big Soleil with replacement blades. Feel the soleil.
All right, here. Math homework?
Check.
Field trip permission slip?
Check.
Protractor?
Check.
Milk money?
Check.
Miniature focusizer?
Miniature what?
Me.
You're not on the list.
Yeah, well, I should be.
Get in.
Thank you.
Keep your child focused by holding off hunger with the help of Kellogg's Maple Brown Sugar Frosted Mini Wheats. 8 layers of fiber with real brown sugar and rich maple flavor.
Oh, it's cozy in here.
Keeps them full, keeps them focused.
This burning itch. Many women think they have a yeast infection when they don't. But these symptoms could mean something more.
How can I know?
Introducing the Vagisil Screening Kit. It tests for vaginal infections at home. Now you can know with a new Vagisil Screening Kit.
Let's face it, even with federal student loans and other financial aid, the real cost for a year of college may be higher than you think. A Chase Education One loan can help with all your school-related expenses, from college basics to basic living expenses. Not to mention the big one, tuition. You can get up to $40,000 a year for most college expenses. With a Chase Education One loan, it's fast and easy, and your check is sent in about a week. Plus, there's no application deadline, no complicated forms, and no payments until after graduation. It's easy. Students can apply in minutes, online or by phone, 24 hours, 7 days a week. Adding a cosigner may lower your interest rate. Call or go online for more money-saving benefits. Plus, repayment can begin after graduation. Finally, the money you need for college, fast. Call 888-663-4650 or visit chased117.com.
Hi, Holly. So, do you want to make 50 bucks the easy way? I'll make 50 bucks just for turning you on to this. It's a 50-50 offer. You get to dump unreliable cable and fall in love with DirecTV. Plus, you get a DVD player and 50 bucks. And I get 50 bucks. What's not to love?
Sign up your friends, and you'll both make 50 bucks. Go to directtv.com/refer.
So, do you want to make 50 bucks the easy way?
I just remembered I left my handkerchief in your dressing room. I'll be back in a flash.
Hello, Barbara.
Hello, Seneca.
It's good to see you well and working again.
Whatever gave you the impression that I'm well? I have no movement, I have no sensation in my legs, I can't walk.
Forrest told me about the ratings. It's good news.
Oh, wonderful. But how long can they keep it up? I mean, how can the best of writers invent good material for a leading lady in a wheelchair?
Oh, come on, the Harcourts are fond of both you and Maggie. I'm sure they're going to have no trouble keeping you busy for a long time.
Why did you come, Dr. Bolak? Surely not to congratulate me on my ratings.
No.
What do you want?
I've come to ask you to postpone your legal action against Roger in the hospital.
Postpone it?
Just put everything on hold for a month or two.
And why, in heaven's name, should I want to do that?
Because I'm certain that with time, the use of your legs will return.
You never give up, do you?
Barbara, I don't want to see you do irreparable damage to the career of a genuinely gifted surgeon.
Your gifted surgeon has done irreparable damage to me and my career. I don't understand how you can think I can overlook that.
Dr. Bolak.
All right.
Excuse me, Barbara. I wonder if you'd have a few minutes just to run over lines. I'm having a very difficult time with the monologue in Act 3, and I've just let the rest slip by.
Certainly. Excuse me, Seneca. If you want to watch the blocking or the run-through, you're welcome to stay, and we can talk during the breaks.
Yeah, thank you. I will.
Bye. Was that a mistake?
No.
Yeah, I had a feeling, you know, you wanted to get rid of him.
I did. For a moment. I just need to be with Maggie for a while.
You okay?
Thank you. That's very sensitive of you.
Well, when you've been married to somebody for a long time, you pick up on those things.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Look, I'd like to discuss the nurse's entrance with you two and Jay. Now,
okay.
The timing has to be just right. So Bigsy and I came up with a new cue that we'd like to try, all right?
Okay.
Now, where's Jane?
She went to my dressing room. She'll be back in a minute.
Jane on set, please, for Maggie's living room, ready to block act three. Jane on set, please. Act three, please.
Next, it's Shocking Secrets in Salem on Days. Then catch the latest scandals on AMC. Later, things are heating up on One Life on SoapNet. Happily ever after. Don't think so.
We are not going to let Philip take your little girl away.
In Salem. Love isn't always a fairy tale.
And never, ever giving up on you.
Days of Our Lives, next on SoapNet.
In life's tricky waters, suddenly the current can change.
Why don't you back off?
It can be muddied by lies.
You chose duty over desire.
Or drowned by the truth.
Over my dead body.
That can be arranged.
The only constant is there's no telling where it will go.
Better watch your step.
Follow the flow. One Life to Live. Weeknights at 9 on SoapNet. This July, SoapNet is fired up.
I'm telling you, it's karma.
Kevin, Adrian, and Colleen team up to take Jenna down.
She needs to be in jail. I still have nightmares about her.
Could their scheme lead to disaster?
That's what you get for trying to kill your boyfriend.
She's going down.
The heat is on.
You are my hero.
Watch The Young and the Restless all July long on SoapNet.
An M&M in everyone. Find yours at MMS.com.
Introducing the Hanes All Over Comfort Bra with comfort soft straps that stay in place. From every angle.
I haven't had time to sort out my feelings about one thing before something else comes along. My resemblance to Marie Carra, my involvement with her, and now Ari. Then Spencer's death. I just haven't regained my equilibrium after the Egyptian ball.
Well, maybe what you need is a large dose of normality. Put some distance between you and ancient Egypt.
But I'm fascinated with ancient Egypt.
And a little scared, maybe?
Yes.
So step back a little bit. Give yourself some perspective.
I think you have something in mind.
Well, look, why don't you start off with a good day's work with your kids? That's challenging and satisfying, isn't it?
Most of the time.
I can see you're not going to be that easy to convince. All right, I'll tell you what. After this great, fulfilling day you're going to have, I'll pick you up for dinner. Steak. The most exotic part of the menu will be French fried onion rings.
Oh, God.
Then we can go down to that country western club on Fifth, listen to some real rowdy music. How's that sound?
Great. Absolute normality. And as American as apple pie. And if you throw in an egg cream at the end of the evening, you've got yourself a deal.
Terrific.
Ah.
What time shall I pick you up? 7?
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Okay.
Ari.
I realize you're due at the hospital soon, but I must speak to you.
No, I've got time. Something's wrong, isn't it?
I'm angry and I'm frustrated. My usual reactions to lawyers and academics.
Jill.
And Jonas Rowling. I just left them at the Smith house. Actually, I walked out. I had to see you. You understand what's at stake for me.
Well, tell me, you'll feel better.
I do already. Just seeing you is an affirmation of what I am doing here in New York.
You're seeing Marie Cara.
I'm seeing my good friend, Faith Coleridge.
Come on in and tell me about it.
Jim, I want you to meet Aristotle Benedict White. Ari, this is Jim Spood.
How do you do?
I owe you an apology for taking Faith away from the museum ball. I trust she gave you the reason why.
Yes, she did.
Good. Jonas and Jillian have informed me that the house is to be sealed while Jonas makes a complete inventory of its contents, which means that I cannot go near my work until he's finished.
How long?
Who knows? It could be weeks. Jonas is in no great hurry.
Well, isn't there some way that you could continue while he does his job?
Apparently not.
Oh, well, of course you're angry. To be called away from your work in Egypt and then asked to cool your heels
Faith, it is so infuriating to be blocked in this way.
I know how you feel. But I think the best thing that you can do right now, until Jonas is finished, is put as much distance between yourself and the Smith collection as you can.
How?
Well, you are in one of the best cities in the world for diversion, and you've seen very little of it. If I go over to the hospital and find someone to cover for me, I'll take the afternoon off and show you some of my favorite places in New York.
That'd be very nice, Faith. Thank you. Before I do anything else, may I use the telephone? Because I realized when I left the Smith house, when I walked out of it, that I hadn't told Jonas that my collection is in it as well as Spencer's. Jillian may forget to remind him, and there's enough confusion surrounding this entire situation as it is.
Oh, sure. Use the phone in the kitchen. It's down the hall.
Thank you.
I've done it again.
Looks that way to me.
I'm sorry. Right in front of you, too.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. I just wasn't there.
I don't know what to say. I'm sorry. Jim, I did what I needed to do. Ari has just been cut off from one of the most important things in the world to him, his work. And I'm the only person that he can talk to about it.
Oh, I'll agree that you're certainly sympathetic.
You're jealous.
I'm concerned. Look, you're involving yourself very deeply with someone you know very little about. From what you told me earlier, it's already cost you a lot. I don't understand why you're so willing to get in deeper.
Because I have felt more alive in the past few days than I have in the last few months. Not including Spencer's death. Now, that was sad and horrible, and I'm sorry that I contributed to it. However, accidentally. I'm not at fault, and neither is Ari.
I never said you were.
Jim, you're a very good friend. You are, and I really appreciate that. And the last thing I would want to do is hurt your feelings. But I have to follow my instincts right now. And they say go for all the excitement and mystery that Ari has to offer. So please, don't try to tell me what to do.
Right. Be seeing you.
Jim,
I'm afraid that Sergeant Speed isn't terribly fond of me.
Jim worries. And I'm so tired of being worried over. Well, if you've taken care of your business, let's run over to the hospital and I'll take care of mine and then we'll be on our way.
Lead on. I'd follow you anywhere.
Will love conquer all? Or are the residents of Salem destined to be miserable? Find out who's pursuing who and who's left brokenhearted. Days of Our Lives, next on SoapNet.
Thank you. Okay, so I doubled up on tequila because those dice jockeys